My name is Rajiv Ratnakumari, working as biological science teacher in Nagarkallu, Guntur district. Children, how are you? I think all are fine. Okay, children, today we are going to learn the new topic in 7th class. In 7th class, this year we got the new textbooks. New textbooks, it is divided into two semesters. So today we are going to learn the first semester of July month syllabus. Okay, children, before going to the topic, I want to ask some few questions. So what are the organisms that live on the earth? So for example, the organisms present on the earth. So children, say some examples, the organisms which are present on the earth. For example, we can see so many organisms around our houses, in schools, near our schools, hospitals or anything. So we can see the organisms present on the air. Example, plants, animals, insects, birds, etc. So children, what are the organisms present on the earth? So near our houses, we can see some organisms, examples, plants, animals, insects, birds. So, how they can live on the earth? So, we are also living on the earth. So, what are our basic needs? How can we live on the earth? So, basic needs of organisms. So, what is the basic need of organisms? So, for example, we say food, water, air. Children, can we live without food, water, air? Even a single minute also, we cannot live without air. So, every organism which can live on the earth, they need food, water, air. So, all these are the basic requirements of the organisms. So, all organisms need food, water, air. But, the food which is important for the organisms, it is different for organism to organism. So, today we are going to know the topic, an interesting topic, that is nutrition in organisms. So, today our topic is nutrition in organisms. So, our July month syllabus, our topic is nutrition in organisms. So, now we are going to know the topic, an interesting topic, nutrition in organisms. There are topics in nutrition in organisms of children. In nutrition in organisms, we can see the modes of nutrition, autotrophic nutrition in plants, essential requirements of raw materials for photosynthesis, saprophytic nutrition, parasitic nutrition, holozoic nutrition, nutrition in amoeba, nutrition in human beings. So, first, we know we see the definition of nutrition. So today, first we learn the topics of modes of nutrition, autotrophic nutrition in plants, and essential requirement of raw materials for photosynthesis. So in nutrition in organisms, In this first session, we learn the modes of nutrition, autotrophic nutrition in plants, essential requirement of raw materials for photosynthesis. So now in this session, we learn these three topics. So children, nutrition means the process of intake of food and utilization of food by organisms is called nutrition. So once again, nutrition means the process of intake of food and utilization of food by organisms is called nutrition. So the process of intake of food. For example, if we see the frog or leeches, so we see the different organisms around us. So they use the, in sixth class also we learn the topic, the body parts which are used to take the food. So organisms, they take the food, but they use the different organs, and they by using these organs, their digestion or nutrition, there is a difference from one organism to another organism. So they take the food in different ways, and it is used in body in different methods. So, and this mode of nutrition is different from one organism to another organism.
Organisms, but we are taking food
But plants are not taking food like us. So how the plants are living like us on the earth? So plants are not taking food, but how they are living on the earth? So today we are going to know this topic of modes of nutrition about the plants and different animals. So now let us go to the topic of modes of nutrition. So in modes of nutrition, the first one is autotrophic nutrition. So in autotrophic nutrition, auto means self, trophos means nourishment. So here auto means self, trophos means nourishment. Plants prepare their own food materials and they don't depend on other organisms for food. So they are called autotrophs. And this mode of nutrition is called autotrophic nutrition. So children, so autotrophic nutrition means here we already told in definition, auto means self. It prepares its own and it does not depend on the other organisms. So it prepares its own food materials. So this autotrophic nutrition means here the plants which prepare its own food materials and it does not depend on the other organisms for food. So this type is called as autotrophs. So for example, plants. So plants prepare their own food materials and it does not depend on the other organisms for food. So they are called autotrophs and this mode of nutrition is called autotrophic nutrition. Modes of nutrition. In modes of nutrition, the first one is autotrophic nutrition. So auto means self, trophos means nourishment. So plants prepare their own food materials and they don't depend on other organisms for food. So they are called autotrophs. And this mode of nutrition is called autotrophic nutrition. So children, so auto means self. So here the plants prepare its own food materials. So it does not depend on any organism. So for that the plants are called as autotrophs. Why plants are autotrophs means they does not depend on the other organisms. It prepares its own food materials so that they are also living on the earth like us. So we are taking food by depending on the plants. In the same way, the plants, they don't eat food like us, but they prepare food by using some factors. So they prepare their own food. So plants are called as autotrophs. And this mode of nutrition, it is called as autotrophic nutrition. So this one is the plant. So this plant is the autotroph. Why? Because it prepares its own food material. So this autotrophic nutrition we can see in plants. Children, in modes of nutrition, we learn autotrophic nutrition. Now we see heterotrophic nutrition. So in heterotrophic nutrition, heteros means other, trophos means nourishment. So heteros means other, trophos means nourishment. So heterotrophic nutrition means they do not prepare their own food material, depend on the other organisms for food. So they are called heterotrophs. Example, animals. And this mode of nutrition is called heterotrophic nutrition. So once again, say the definition after me. Heterotrophic nutrition. So they do not prepare their own food material, depend on other organisms for food. So they are called heterotrophs. Examples: animals. And this mode of nutrition is called heterotrophic nutrition. So in heterotrophic nutrition, for example, near our houses we can see dog, cat, birds. They eat different food items and they depend on the other organisms. So they are called as the heterotrophic organisms. So in mode of nutrition, we have learned the autotrophic nutrition and the heterotrophic nutrition. So autotrophic nutrition means plants, and the heterotrophic nutrition examples, animals. So, and now we have given one table in the textbook based on the autotrophs and the heterotrophs. So now let us complete the table. So children, now let us complete the activity which was given in the textbook. Depend upon the autotrophic nutrition and the heterotrophic nutrition. So see the headings which was given in the table. So the first column is serial number, and the second column is name of the organism, and the third column is prepares own food or depend on other organisms for food, and the last column is inference autotroph or heterotroph. So what are the examples given in column? Mango tree, cat, rose plant, mushroom, leech, goat, human beings. So the first one is mango tree. So say children, mango tree prepare its own food or depend on the other organisms. So say one thing, mango tree prepares its own food. Prepares its own food. So which prepares its own food? It is called autotrophs. And second one, cat. Cat depend on other organism. Depend on other organism for food. So they are called heterotroph. Next, rose plant prepare its own food. So it is called autotroph. Next, mushroom depends on other organism. So it is called heterotroph. Next, leech depend on other organism for food. So it is also called heterotroph. Next, goat depends on other organism for food. So it is also called heterotroph. Human beings depends on also draw the column and put the headings and complete the table, and you write some more examples of autotrophs and the heterotrophs. So from this table, mango tree prepares its own food, autotroph. Cat depend on other organism for food, so it is a heterotroph. Rose plant prepares its own food, autotroph. Mushroom depends on other organism for food, it is a heterotroph. Next, leech depend on other organism for food. So mushroom depend on the other organisms for food, heterotrophs. Next, leech depend on other organism for food, heterotroph. Goat depends on other organism for food, heterotrophs. Human beings depends on other organism for food, heterotrophs. So from the given table, how many are autotrophs and how many are heterotrophs? So from this table, mango tree and rose plant both are autotrophs, and the cat, mushroom, leech, goat, human beings, these five are heterotrophs. So children, you add some more examples of autotrophs and heterotrophs. So all plants are autotrophs. So I want to ask one question, all plants are autotrophs? No, some plants are not autotrophs. For example, mushrooms. So the mushrooms which we take as a food, it is a not a autotroph, it is a non-green plant. It depends for food on the dead and the decaying organisms. So mushroom is a non-green plant. So it is not a autotroph. So some plants are, they cannot, non-green plants are, they can't prepare their own food materials, but they depend on the other organisms. It is also depends on the other for the food. So they are the heterotrophs. So here some more examples of autotrophs and the heterotrophs, and you also complete the given table. And have you seen forest, children? So forests are also green in color. Why forests are green in color? So forest means full of trees. It is a full of trees. So what is the color of trees? It is the green. Why trees are green? Because the trees contain leaves which are green in color. Why the leaves are green in color? Because it contains a chloroplast organelle which contains a chlorophyll pigment. So due to the chlorophyll pigment in leaves, the leaves are green in color. Therefore, the leaves are green in color, the trees are green in color. So with the full of trees, so we it's appear like the forest are green in color. Let us see some pictures of forest.
Okay children, now observe the forest. See the color of forest, because it is green due to the chloroplast which consists of the chlorophyll. So due to it, it occurs in green in color.
Next, before we are going to the topic, we see the pictures. See, now our today's second topic is autotrophic nutrition. So table is given in textbook. So what is the items given in textbook? So first one is the preparation of boiled rice, preparation of suitable green plants. Okay children, now first we see one example. So if you want to make any recipe, in 6th class we learned that upma preparation, tomato curry preparation. So if you want to prepare any food item, we need some ingredients. So for example, we have seen one activity, how can we make the upma snack food item. So what are the ingredients we have taken? Rolon, oil, green chilies, mustard seeds, etc. So we have taken some ingredients to prepare upma. In the same way, here in autotrophic nutrition, we want to know about the autotrophic nutrition. Here we have given some example. One is the preparation of boiled rice, and the other one is the preparation of food by green plants. So here, once we recall again upma in 6th class, what are the ingredients needed? In the same way, here also given what is the raw materials required for boiled rice and the green plants. Next, what is the source of energy needed for preparation of boiled rice and green plants? Next, where it happens, one particular place for boiled rice and green plants. Next, finally, what the product forms. So let us see what are the raw materials required for boiled rice. Rice and water. So every day our mother prepares food for us. How she cooks? She takes the raw rice and water and she boils in a cooker or she put on a gas stove. So raw materials, what it we need? Rice and water. So what is the energy she have given? 5 from the stove. And where she cooks it? Vessel of the cooker. So by using all this our mother prepared for us boiled rice. So once again, see children, so every day you are observing while your mother prepares food for you. For example, boiled rice, she have taken the raw materials or ingredients, rice or water. Next, for cooking it, we need some energy. So what is the energy she given? 5 from the stove. Next, if we want to cook it, we need some vessel or cooker. So she cooked it in a vessel or cooker. So finally, we got the boiled rice. In the same way, the green plants, before we thought that autotrophs means the plants which prepare its own food materials, they are called as autotrophs. So green plants also need the ingredients. So what are the ingredients needed for green plants? So the raw materials needed for green plants is carbon dioxide, water. Next, so to prepare food, our mother used stove, but plants use sunlight as a energy, and we use to cook the rice, we use the cooker, but in the leaves, the vessel of cooker, it acts as a chloroplast, which contains a chlorophyll. Next, finally forms here boiled rice. Here, finally we got the end product, glucose or the carbohydrates. So to prepare one product or to prepare one recipe, or if we prepare one material, it needs some raw materials and some energy, and to prepare it, it should need a particular place, and finally we get the end product. By using all these, from we got the boiled rice and from the green plants we got the glucose. So children, here we have given some questions from table. So again, you observe the table, note down in the your notebooks and write the answers for given questions by seeing table and observe it carefully. And in table, we have given 4 questions. So you write the answers for 4 questions. See, what are the raw materials required for the preparation of food by green plants? So preparation of food by green plants, what is the raw materials? Carbon dioxide and water. Next, which gas is taken by plants during this process? Which gas it is used? That one is the carbon dioxide. And name the food material formed in plants. So what is the food material formed? Glucose or carbohydrates. Next, what do you conclude from the above information? So we want to get a product, we need some raw material. a particular place to form the end product. So once again I am repeating the questions. Again observe children and write the answers. So what are the raw materials needed? Carbon dioxide and the water. Next, which gas is taken by plants during this process? Carbon dioxide. Name the food material formed in plants. Glucose or carbohydrate. Next, what do you conclude from the above information? So if we want to prepare any food material or anything, we need some raw materials and energy. So note down in your notebooks. Okay children, in the table 2 we have seen that the plants use the raw materials carbon dioxide, water and energy as the sunlight. And where it takes place? In a chloroplast of a leaf which contains the chlorophyll. So from the table, the end product in green plants, what it formed? Carbohydrate. So on based on it, we have written one equation. How the food prepared by green plants? So the green plants use the carbon dioxide, water and sunlight energy in the presence of chlorophyll, and it forms the carbohydrate and releases the oxygen into the atmosphere. So once again listen children. So in the given table, the preparation of food by green plants. So children, now before we learn the raw materials required for photosynthesis in the form of equation. So what is that? Carbon dioxide plus water, and which uses light energy in the presence of chlorophyll, forms the end product. Okay children, in before topic we learned that the equation, the photosynthesis equation, what are the raw materials required for photosynthesis? Carbon dioxide, water, uses the sunlight in the presence of chlorophyll, and it forms the end product carbohydrate, oxygen and the water. Okay children, before that I want to ask you one question. So we have already learned that in 6th class also equation. Next, this carbon dioxide, sunlight, water and chlorophyll, all these are the raw materials. So in 6th class what we learned that, sir, upma preparation we need the ingredients. So here we are taking example that upma preparation. So the raw materials which are required for photosynthesis: chlorophyll, water, carbon dioxide and the sunlight. Before that I want to ask one question. Okay na children? Say, so for upma preparation we need some ingredients. For example, rulam, mustard, oil. So if we want to prepare upma, where we will bring the ingredients? So where should we get the ingredients to prepare upma? So we bring that ingredients from the market. Or if we want to prepare any special item or want to prepare any goods or products, we need some materials. So we want to go to the market and to bring the materials to prepare any item. In the same way, here the food is the end product, or carbohydrate is the end product which was the starch formed in the plants. So it also needed some raw materials. So plants need some raw materials to prepare the food material. So where the plant it gets? So where this plant gets all these raw materials to prepare the food preparation? So now first one we see that chlorophyll. So if we observe in a plant, so we take one leaf. leaf. So this leaf contains chloroplast. This chloroplast contains chlorophyll pigment. This chlorophyll pigment plays a key role in photosynthesis. So what is this key role? This chlorophyll pigment present in the leaf, it gives a green color to the leaf, and also it absorbs the sunlight and light energy to prepare the food. So understand children? So else again I will repeat. So the main raw material for photosynthesis is the chlorophyll. Where this chlorophyll present? It is present in a chloroplast. So where this chloroplast present? It is in a leaf. So what is the use of this chlorophyll? This chlorophyll gives the green color to the leaf, and also it helps in the preparation of food material, in the process of food preparation of photosynthesis. So this chlorophyll plays a key role in giving the green color to the leaf, and also in the preparation of food material by the process of photosynthesis. So next one is the water. So in 6th class we learned that one activity. So what is that, children? Once all of you recall it, how the plants absorb the water. So if you observe the roots, if you observe the roots of a plant, the roots absorbs the water and minerals from the soil. So the roots absorbs the water and minerals from the soil. So it absorbs the water and minerals from the soil, and it passes to the stem, stem to branches, and branches to the leaves of a plant. We have done activity in 6th class also, how the roots absorbs the water. So the roots absorbs the water and minerals from the soil, and it is transported to the stem, branches, and the leaves of a plant. So in this way the roots help in absorbing the water and it transported to all parts of the plant. Next one is what, children? Carbon dioxide. So where the carbon dioxide is present? Carbon dioxide is present in atmosphere. So we all know that air is a mixture of gases. Air is a mixture of gases. So air is a mixture of gases means it contains nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, all are present in air, and also the some of the water vapor, all these gases are present in air. So air is called as a mixture. So the plants absorb the carbon dioxide from atmosphere through which organ, children? So how do you breathe? Say the answer. Yes, we all breathe in and breathe out through nose. So like that, plants is also having one special organ present in the leaf. So what is that organ means? That is the stomata. That is the stomata. This stomata which closes and opens. This stomata, by the opening and closing of stomata, in exchange of gases takes place through the stomata. By opening and closing of stomata, exchange of gases takes place through the stomata. So this stomata is present in the lower epidermis of the leaf. In the lower epidermis of the leaf, there is a numerous number of chloroplasts are present, stomata are present. In the lower epidermis of the leaf, numerous number of stomata is present. This stomata helps in the exchange of the gases. So this stomata is called as the nose of the leaf. how our nose functions by taking the air, that is the how we are breathe in and breathe out. Like the leaf also helps in taking of carbon dioxide and releases out the oxygen. So the leaf which takes the carbon dioxide and releases out the oxygen, and it is released into the atmosphere. So that is the function of stomata. Next, so the water is absorbed by the roots. Next, this chlorophyll plays a key role in photosynthesis, and it also absorbs the sunlight energy. So all these raw materials which are helpful in the photosynthesis for the preparation of food materials. So the roots absorbs water along with minerals. That is, the minerals means macronutrients and micronutrients. What are they? That is the nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, and also the micronutrients are iron, ferrous. All these are the micronutrients. So by using all these raw materials, the plants use them, all these raw materials, and prepares the food or carbohydrate, and it is stored in the form of starch, and this process it is called as the photosynthesis. Next, there is a special plants, they are called as the insectivorous plants. So these plants, they are grown in the nitrogen deficient soils. So they eat the insects. These plants, they eat the insects. Why they eat the insects? Because they grow in, these insectivorous plants grow in nitrogen deficient soils. So lack of this nitrogen, how they take these plants? They take nitrogen, they fulfill the deficiency of nitrogen by taking the insects. So the plants modify their leaves to trap the insect, and they take the nitrogen from the insects. So they are called as the insectivorous plants. So this is one of the type of the insectivorous plants. So they take the food material as the insects to take the nitrogen which was grown in the nitrogen deficient soils. So examples are Venus fly. So examples of insectivorous plants are Venus fly, Drosera, and the Euterpleura. So all these are the examples of the insectivorous plants.
So children, now see the how the photosynthesis takes place in plants. Plants make their own food by the process of photosynthesis. So photosynthesis is the process used by the plants to make their food. If we observe how the plants taking the carbon dioxide and the light energy by the plants. So photo means light, and the synthesis means putting together. The plants absorbs the light energy, water, nutrients from the soil for photosynthesis. So it takes the carbon dioxide from the atmosphere, water from the soil, and the light energy from the sunlight, and the water is transported to the all the parts of the plant through the xylem. If you observe children, how the water is transported through the xylem in the plants, see, this one is the xylem. The water and the minerals are transported from the soil through the roots to all the other parts of the plant, like how the blood is transported in our body. See, this one is the stomata, which helps in the exchange of the gases, which is present in the lower epidermis of the leaf. So it takes the carbon dioxide and releases the oxygen out into the atmosphere. So this stomata helps in the exchange of the gases. See, the chloroplast is present in the leaf. It contains the pigment chlorophyll, which helps to absorb the light energy and also helps in the preparation of the carbohydrate in the leaves. So carbon dioxide plus water in the presence of chlorophyll and uses the light energy to produce the glucose and the oxygen. Oxygen is released into the atmosphere. So this is the process of photosynthesis.
Children, we have learned that the what is the importance of plants and the how the plants prepared in a food. This process, it is called as a photosynthesis. And one more question. So how we are taking out oxygen by the plants? So only on the universe, only the plants only prepare the food material for all the organisms which are present on the earth. So the plants are called as the universal food providers. So whatever the organism which are present on the earth, they get the food materials directly or indirectly, depend all the organisms on the plants. So the plants are called as the universal food providers. And the in where this photosynthesis takes place, it takes place in the leaves. So the leaves are called as the food factories of the plant. Leaves are called as the food factories of the plant, and the plants are called as the universal food providers. So where does we all get oxygen? So we all get oxygen also from the plants, which release into the atmosphere by the process of photosynthesis. The plants take the carbon dioxide and release the oxygen into the atmosphere. So we have to appreciate our plants, what they are playing a key role on this universe for every organism which are living on the earth. So as a science student, we all have each one plant one tree. So each one plant one tree. So now we have learned the uses of plants, how they are providing all the food and oxygen which was to survive on the earth. So children, you have one activity. So everyone today should plant one tree. So this is also one of the work I have given to you. So now let us note down the worksheet work. So children, so what we have learned today? So once we recall the topic, what we have learned today session. So first one, we have learned the definition of nutrition. So what is the modes of nutrition? Autotrophic nutrition and heterotrophic nutrition. And we have filled the activities which was in the textbook. Next, the autotrophic nutrition and how the plants prepare its food materials, what are the raw materials required, and the photosynthesis. All these are the topics we have learned in this session. Okay children, now let us take the worksheet. So next session, by next session, you have to complete your worksheet work and write the answers, and everyone should write the worksheet answers. Now note down the worksheet. All the children, now note down the worksheet. So the first one, the food factories of the plant. A, root. B, stem. C, flower. D, leaf. Next, second question. Starch can be identified by dash solution. Starch can be identified by dash solution. Next, third one. Autotroph example. Next, fourth one. Give some examples of heterotrophs. Next, fifth one. Define photosynthesis and write equation. Next, fifth question. Define photosynthesis and write equation. Okay children, all of you complete worksheet work by next session. Next, children, now it is a COVID time, so all must follow the some health and hygiene and wear mask and maintain social distance and thoroughly wash your hands and create awareness your parents and grandparents to take vaccine. So prevention is better than cure. So we must follow all these rules to prevent the COVID. So stay home, stay safe.